Now let us do questions of the lesson. First we'll take up short answer questions, 30-40 words. First question is, what was the basic scheme of Jack's stories? Now Jack used to tell a story to his daughter every day. The basic scheme of all stories was the same. Every day the story that he told had a basic tale. There was a rosal creature, rosal fish or rosal squirrel, something like that. And that creature had a problem. Then it would go to the wise old owl. The wise old owl would send him to the wizard. The wizard would solve his problem with his magic stick. And after that, the wizard would charge some pennies from the creature. And he would always ask for more pennies than the creature had. And then the creature would start crying. He would send that creature to the end of the lane. He would tell him, go to the end of the lane, take rounds. That is, if there were three pennies falling short, he would say, take three rounds and you would get three pennies in the magic well there. And like that, the creature would get more pennies. He would pay the pennies to the wizard and go home happily. So that was the basic tale of all Rosa's stories that Jack told. Second question is, who was Rosa Skunk? Rosa Skunk was a creature in the jungle. He was a child and he gave out a very foul smell. So what was his problem? Due to his foul smell, the other creatures of the jungle did not play with him and he felt very sad. Next question is, what personal experience did Jack recall while telling the skunk story? While telling the skunk story, Jack recalled his own childhood experience, his own childhood humiliations, when he also suffered from some problem like that and he did not have any friends. So his mother used to tell him that it would be over, everybody would accept him with the passage of time, and it did happen. So that experience he wanted to link with this story, with the skunk story, that the skunk had a foul smell, that was his problem, and the other creatures did not play with him, they ran away from him, that was his problem. But the mother said that the foul smell was for the protection of the skunk, so it should be there, and with the passage of time all other creatures accepted him. So this is what Jack wanted to convey to his daughter, that nature's ways are good for the good of all creatures and we should not interfere with those ways. Next is, what did the skunk's mother do on finding him smell of roses? When the skunk's mother realized that, when she found that her child skunk was smelling like roses, he had the scent of roses, she got angry, she got worried, because that foul smell that he had was his original smell and that was his smell which protected him. So she got worried, she immediately took the child, the skunk, and she took an umbrella with her, rushed back, went to the wizard, hit him on the head and ordered him to change his foul smell back, to change his rose smell, scent of roses, back to his foul smell, the original smell. And the wizard did it. Now she was happy. She was now free from the worry, because otherwise her child was not safe. Next question is, what was the reality phase that Joe was passing through? The reality phase is when Jack was telling Joe the stories. So now what happened was, he had been telling her stories for the past 2 years. When she was 2 years old, he started telling her the stories. Now she was 4 years old. She was now questioning in between the stories. She wanted to know the reality behind everything. When the mother said, God is there all around us, she said, is he there? When the father said, spiders eat bugs, she asked her mother, do they really? Like that, she would ask questions to know the reality. So that was the reality phase. That is, she was growing now and she wanted to know the reality behind everything. That is why the writer says that was the reality phase. Next question is, Why did Jack feel caught in an ugly middle position? In the end, Jack feels caught in an ugly middle position because his daughter Jo has not accepted the truth that he wants to tell her. She wanted that the story should have a happy ending, that the child skunk should have the scent of roses, because that would make him happy. He would play with other creatures of the jungle. So she felt that the story should end over there. But that day the story did not end happily, because every day it had a happy ending, but this skunk story did not have a happy ending. Now she felt she did not like that ending which her father had given. The father said that the scent of roses was not good for the child, so the mother got the smell of the foul smell back to the child skunk, and now this ending she did not like. So the father Jack wanted to convey to her the truth of life, that whatever nature has given us is for our good, we should accept it, and the child skunk should also be having his foul smell rather than scent of roses. This she does not want to accept. So the father is not able to convince her. That is why in the end Jack feels himself caught in an ugly middle position, because he wants to convey to her something which is true and she is not accepting that. In the same way he feels himself caught in a cage, and he feels his wife is also caught in a cage. What does he mean here? He and his wife means the adults are caught in a cage, means they are not able to, when they are not able to convince their children about something that is right. So in the same way he was feeling caught in a ugly middle position. Now the question next is a long answer question. What is the moral question raised in the story? The moral question raised in the story is, are the parents right in their thinking towards their children? They always want the welfare of their children. Are they right or they wrong? Should the wizard hit mommy? Is the wizard right or the mother is right? Is the child right? Is Joe right? Then another question is, should we interfere with the ways of nature? Again, the message is we should not. So we can link this answer with the theme of the story. Next is, how is a child's worldview different from that of an adult? Again, we can say the child's worldview is different in the sense that here in the story, Joe feels that there should be happiness, the children should be happy. If the skunk child had a foul smell, the children did not play with him, he was not happy. When the wizard changed his smell to the scent of roses, she was happy that now the skunk was happy. But she did not know that this foul smell was good for that child. And so we can say the children are inexperienced, they do not know the reality, they do not know the truth about the world. So they have a different view of the world, whereas the adults have a different view of the world because they are experienced, they know the truth, they know the reality, they know what is good and what is bad for their children. So we can link this answer also with the story. There is one more question that is left to be discussed, and that is question number 7, 30-40 words. The question is, what do you know about Claire in the story? Claire is Jack's wife and she is mostly busy in her household work. She is not interested in the storytelling sessions that Jack has with his daughter. And moreover, she is not interested in hearing Jack's stories about cocktail parties. She only pretends pleasure. And Claire is 6 months pregnant. And right now when Jack is telling the story to Joe, she is busy doing paintwork on furniture in the living room. And Jack knows that after finishing with the storytelling, he should go and help his wife Claire in doing paint work. She should not be doing this work alone. He should help her. And after telling the story, when he goes downstairs to the living room, Claire asked him that was a long story. It took a lot of time. So Jack was not able to explain to her, because Jack was already dissatisfied. He had not been able to convince his daughter about the truth of life. He had not been able to convince that the mother, the skunk mother, was right. And so he was in a very disturbed mood. He was dissatisfied and he was not in a good mood. So he felt as if he was caught in a ugly middle position, and he felt as if he was caught in a cage and his wife also in the same cage. That is the perspective of the old, perspective of the adults, and the perspective of the children. His child Joe was not able to understand what he wanted to convey to her. So Claire is Jack's wife, not much role in storytelling.